My name is Carl Soule. I am going to spend the next 30 minutes talking about some of the new features inside of Premiere Pro. Also just talking about some of the flexibility in Premiere to let you edit the way you want to edit. We just released a new version of Premiere. You'll notice we have this new header bar up at the top of Premiere, and in the upper left corner, we've got a new import option that's listed here. And we wanted to kind of give a new experience, a more visual experience to import, to kind of modernize this inside of Premiere. Premiere does this really cool thing where it builds out a little set of storyboards down at the bottom, so I kind of see an order in which these clips are coming in. But best of all, these import settings over on the side here, we make it very, very easy to just click one button to copy the media. And if I twirl this down, I can pick the exact location I want the media to copy to. When we're adding this to a project, do we want to have the footage come into a new bin? Do we also want to create some sort of a string out sequence? We can actually do that now all in one simple step. Now, the other thing that the header bar also offers is we've just added a very simple full screen option button. JK and L playback works in this mode. We have a quick export button in the upper corner. We've also added this drop-down button here to find the workspaces. We just want to make sure that Premiere will let you edit the way you want to edit and get out of the way so you can be creative. There's a new feature in the markers panel that we just added for this release that actually lets you show and hide markers by color. So if you color code your markers so that an assistant editor can have a completely different set of markers from the lead editor, now you have that capability. We now have speech to text built directly inside of Adobe Premiere. I'm going to go to my captions and graphics workspace. And you can see here we have this new text panel over on the side here. I'm just going to go into the transcript tab in this panel and click on Create Transcription. Now, this doesn't just work on English. I think there's about 14 different languages. If I needed to give this to a producer, I could choose to export this to a text file or a CSV file. If I'm using this in editing, if I need to find a particular word, resident, I can see there's two instances of that. I can tap on a word, and you can see my playhead moves to that word. We can click on Create Captions. And in one quick step, and by the way, this isn't just subtitles. This does work for closed captioning as well as open captioning. The accuracy that we're seeing with this engine is typically somewhere in the 97 to 98% range. With Lumetri, we have all kinds of different tools for working with color. But a lot of people just want to do something very, very quick. They just need to make it look good. Adobe has applied Sensei technology, our machine learning AI technology, and basically fed a huge data set of a bunch of video clips and what the manual settings were to adjust those to make them pleasing to the human eye. So what this means is there is now a new auto button, which we call auto color. Look for the little, I don't know if you can see it from up there, but it's got a little magic wand next to it. Auto color doesn't go crazy, doesn't do anything too insane. It looks and analyzes the situation, looks into its deep library of what other people have done in similar situations, and it adjusts the sliders for you so that this can be a better starting position. And I'm going to go a little deeper into Lumetri color, and I'm going to use the comparison view option in here. Our Sensei will go through and analyze the color on the left and try to apply that color to the clip on the right. So I'm going to leave face detection on. That does a better job of matching skin tone if I have that on. I'll go ahead and hit apply match. And there it's gone through and done more of a match. Last year, Frame.io became a part of the Adobe family. Now, Frame.io comes included with your Creative Cloud membership. And we've got a new review workspace. So I'm just going to click on that. Under the window menu, Review with Frame.io is now just built right into the application. Something else that's included with your Frame.io membership is Camera to Cloud. It's this idea of being able to shoot on the camera the moment you hit stop, a file gets uploaded to Frame.io and is available for editorial almost instantly. Last thing I very quickly want to show you, now you have one export tab that you can go back and forth between. If you're outputting a media file, if you're outputting to YouTube, if you need a different format media file, you can add that as well. You can use the same presets that you set up with for the quick export panel. All of that works the same with the preset manager, all brand new. Thank you guys so much. I'm completely out of time.